If you record interviews with many guests in Riverside, the new feature that was added this month allows you to schedule multiple sessions in advance. And you can schedule up to 3 sessions in advance on the Pro plan, and on the Business plan, unlimited sessions. Let me show you how it works. So I'm in Riverside right now. On the top left here on the sidebar, you can see your studios. And if you go to a studio on the dropdown, here's my Media Makers Club podcast. If I open that, you can already see some of the projects that I planned in advance with the date of recording. But that's coming from the scheduled section. So when I go to scheduled, I can see all of the sessions that I scheduled in advance, the date and the details, and the people who were invited to them. So it's really easy to do this. Let's just schedule one right now. If I go to another call, maybe I want to schedule something with Chris, my friend. So I go in here and then I go to scheduled. And I have no sessions right now. And as I said, on the Pro plan, you can schedule up to 3 sessions in advance. And on the Business plan, unlimited. So I'm going to go and click here to schedule a new session. I can choose the date in here. I will choose one for the next Saturday. And then the time. And of course, the duration here for an hour. And then you can choose your time zone in here. And you can invite the people by using their email. Or you can just copy the link after to the studio to invite them to record. But if I type in here the email, I can invite my friend Chris. I will add him. Type a name in here, of course. And then click Create Session. And right away, the scheduled session is going to show up in here. And you can go to the 3 dots here on the right-hand side to invite more people to edit the details of this recording or to copy this to your Google Calendar for easy scheduling. And a nice feature I like about Riverside is that every studio has a fixed URL. So you can add that link of the studio itself to your calendar invites, to your Calendly booking website, and the link will always be the same and it will be automatically sent to your guests. You don't need to change that at all. If you want to get that link, you go to the 3 dots again and you go to invite people. And here at the top, you have share a link. And this is the link to your studio. You can copy the link and email it yourself or add it to Calendly or your whatever your calendar application is. And make sure you invite the person with the right role. So if you invite a guest to record with them and have them on your podcast, you invite them as a guest. If you invite someone as a producer, that person will not be recorded. So you make sure that you give the guest the correct link. And of course, the audience, if you're doing a webinar or you want to have the link for the audience to watch your live stream. So that's a different type of link right there. Thank you for watching. I hope this tip was helpful. And if you wish to sign up for Riverside to record your podcast, check the link in the description for a coupon to get a discount with your subscription. And this video is indeed sponsored by Riverside. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.